Hi, I'm Erica.
And I'm Karen. Welcome to Pregnancy Place Online. We have with us today Shira Fogel of Tiny Talkers.
Hi.
Hi.
And so we're going to be chatting with you today about baby sign language and the importance of that. And we have brought in the expert when it comes to that. We're so happy to have you.
Thank you.
On Pregnancy Place Online. You are an instructor in the Portland area and you teach all over the place, but we get to kind of open it up to really the world and we get to share you with anybody anywhere through the online classes through Pregnancy Place Online.
I'm so excited for the opportunity to be able to do that.
And with our classes, they're webinars with video, so it's not an audio webinar, and that's perfect for your particular topic because we need to see what you're doing.
Yep, and it's great to be able to interact too, so that you know they can ask me questions and I can give them some answers.
Absolutely. So if you're new to Pregnancy Place Online and we're talking about thinking as we're talking through this, think it through that when you take one of our classes, it's actually video streaming both ways. So if you have a webcam at home, Shira will get to see you and you'll get to see Shira. So that's the class that we're looking at. But talk to us about Tiny Talkers.
Well, the class that I teach is a two-hour workshop. It's called Baby Sign Language 101. And the idea is that I can give you all the information that you need to know to just really give you a good jump start on signing with your baby and not have to have weeks and weeks and weeks of class. Because really, you need the basic information and then it's all up to you to begin repetitively working on it at home. It really lies with you to keep practicing it. So,
what type of sign language do you use in your classes? Do you make up signs like babbling or
American Sign Language?
Okay.
I'm a big believer that you should teach American Sign Language. It's an actual language.
And,
if you're making up language, there's some problems with, you know, later on if somebody else wants to understand what your child is saying.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah,
how do you universal?
Yeah. Absolutely. And as far as why you would want to sign with your baby, because that confuses a lot of people. It's for hearing babies, and that does confuse people. The reason why is because there's been so much research done on babies' brain development, and what we realize now is that babies understand language so much earlier than we ever gave them credit for. So starting as early as about 5 months of age, babies understand a good portion of what's going on. And of course you can understand their frustration and that they can't reciprocate that language with you. But as early as 5 to 6 months of age, they have that manual dexterity. So to be able to make signs, they've got that manual dexterity. They've got the cognitive ability and the memory to be able to put sign language together. So it acts as sort of a bridge before the language is developed so they can communicate to you as a temporary means with sign language.
And isn't it, isn't it both not cognitive development but then also muscular development in that the gross motor skills, the bigger muscles, they get control over those better and faster than all the fine, tiny little muscles.
All the things that go into speaking, you know, the vocal cords don't fully develop until the earliest 16 months of age. And then there's breath and there's tongue coordination. There's so much that goes into speech that we just take for granted. So, you know, you can see your young babies playing with toys. You can see that they can take a toy and pass it from one hand to the other. So you know they've got that manual dexterity and that's what they need to be able to make the signs.
So what is the first few signs that you would focus on? So, I mean, I see you doing a few.
Milk is the number one sign that I usually recommend. You know, one of the great things about signing with your baby is when they first start to, they say their first couple of words, it's usually mama, dada, maybe some cutesy little words. And while mama and dada are helpful, wouldn't it be so much more helpful if they could say milk to you, more? Those are the things that sign language helps you to do. It gets beyond just the basic, very easy babbling words,
right?
Because they can communicate it with their hands. And those are words that are going to make your life so much easier because it's going to eliminate the guessing game.
And that's that frustration.
That's the biggest thing that sign language does, is it takes away the guessing game and reduces frustration. And when you get two-way communication between a parent and a child, that really sets the stage for all communication for the rest of their life. And really, simply put, parenting becomes more fun when you have that two-way communication much earlier. So,
there's a bonding aspect to it and a trust aspect that you're building trust. You're building that, you know, that when I say something, mommy will respond versus, I don't know.
Absolutely. So
we actually use sign while my kids were little. Now those two are almost 15 and almost 13. And I didn't realize how much I used because it just blended into our language development. I didn't realize how much we used until I watched our home videos.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of sign. There was more. We used shoe. We used chicken and all, you know, everything that was in our everyday life. Yeah. But it was really fun.
It's well, and one thing I appreciate about your class specifically, I mean, because I, you know, when I think I have some, I felt like when I had my children, I had a little background in it. I mean, I had, you know, I knew signs before I was a parent, but I could see where it could be a little overwhelming. If you don't know anything about it, but you kind of understand, oh, I want to do that, but then do I have to learn, you know, all of these signs and all that? But I appreciated in your workshop specifically that it's not just, here's the sign for cheese, here's the sign for this, here's the sign for this. It's understanding how and when to incorporate it into daily life, and actually you teach mom and dad how to teach the baby the signs, you know, and so that to me was a significant difference in that it's like, well, what's the difference in taking your class
or reading the book?
I aim to pick up the pieces where books don't take it that step further. I actually have a lot of parents in my class who tried to go at it by themselves with just a book and just felt like it wasn't enough.
Because when you're looking at a book, you're looking at something written for somebody who's already developed language. And so what you're doing is you're also, you're incorporating it into the actual development of the child too, which is a huge difference.
Big difference. Yeah.
So we really appreciate, I mean, obviously appreciate you as a resource, and we want to make sure that we share that with you.
When is the best time to take this class?
I usually like to see parents in my class between 5 and 8, when their baby is between 5 and 8 months old. That's usually, that makes up the biggest crowd.
Well, and you've gotten past the whole right after baby's born, you know, it's like there's no time to do anything other than survive sometimes.
And if you take it, you know, much earlier, you can certainly start working on it earlier, but I just don't want parents to get frustrated that they're waiting that much longer till their baby is, you know, cognitively able to understand it. And of course, you know, I have parents in my class who have 18 to 20 month old because their language is just delayed and it hasn't started yet. So it's never too late to take it, but ideally between 5 and 8 months old.
And for you, how often do you have classes running? You've got local classes.
I usually have about 3 classes a month.
And then we're going to be offering the webinar class probably every couple months or something like that. And we haven't worked out the schedule, but you can always check our calendar on Pregnancy Place Online to find out when the next Tiny Talkers workshop is coming up. And then they just go onto your website.
Go onto my website and register using PayPal. It's pretty easy. And
what is the URL for that?
www.tinytalkersportland.com.
Great, thank you.
Well, thanks for joining
us.
And we look forward to sharing more of you with our listening audience.
Thank you. So excited.
So for Pregnancy Place Online, I'm Karen.
And I'm Erica.